Okay, everyone, welcome back to the channel. Matt with Green Bar Trading, and welcome back to another trade breakdown video where I go over everything that I was looking at in trading TBLA this morning. All right, so hit that thumbs up for the video. If you're new, consider subscribing. We have new videos on day trading and the stock market every day. So, and also come over, join our Twitter. This is at Mr. Greenbar for some interesting things that I post on a daily basis as well. So going into the trade. Now, what did I like about TBLA? I liked the news catalyst. Now, everything, this is our pre-market gap scanner. It's very simple to make. All you want to do is find those stocks that are gapping up the most by mark percent change. All right? Very clear leader here. Very clear. Very clear volume here. Leader. All the eyes are on it. The top of the gap scanner. This is what I like. Very nice price. Right? A lot of retail traders love to trade something that's between, you know, $2 and $3. I mean, that's ideal. All right. What is not ideal is the float. The float is very high. But I'll go into that in a second. We have to look at the catalyst first. So this is our fresh catalyst for this stock. Now, this is what, I'll make this a little bit bigger for you guys. So this is why the stock is up so much in the pre-market. They entered into a 30-year agreement with Yahoo. All right. So you have a very cheap stock that just entered a massive agreement for advertising with Yahoo. Yahoo reaches 900 million monthly active users. So that's very good for this small company. All right. So as part of the agreement, Yahoo will receive almost 25% of the outstanding shares. Now, why is that important? This lowers the float, the shares outstanding, right? They're going to take 25% of those and lock them up as institutional owners. So that just drops the outstanding shares, the float, 25%. All right, so what was a very high float just got knocked down by 25%, which is good. You know, trading today, that Yahoo is not selling their 25% share in this stock. So that was good. That might keep the stock, you know, it might keep it up for the day instead of these just fading and going away. And it is a very good agreement for this company as well. So keep that in mind. It's always about the news catalyst. And if you get a good enough news catalyst, you can see charts that look like this. All right. Now we're going to look at this on a bigger screen here for you guys. This blue indicator, that's the 9 EMA. This is VWAP, this yellow line. When you're over VWAP, that is a good sign for momentum stocks. I hate trading anything under VWAP. That means that we have a very bullish stock, very bullish action. Now, all pre-market up until now, it has bounced off of this 9. All right, so the initial moves, if it has good momentum, will be supporting the 9 EMA. And that's exactly what happened here. I got into my trade right here. But let's take a look first at the float. All right, coming over here to float checker, just type it in. It's so simple. And then you get your float here, which is a very high float. You know, 200 million, 145 million. This is an extremely high float Now chop 25% off of that float, and it's still a very, very high float. So this could be more of a grinder, right? A stock that's grinding on the day. And it is up almost, it is up over 60% already. So it got a little extended, but where I got in, I'll show my trades. I just got in with a lump sum here of 2,000 shares. It was bouncing along the 9 EMA, felt very confident going into that new 5-minute candle. That's what I was trying to get into here at the 709 mark. Got in 2,000 shares. And now the way that I got out of this was I wanted to scale out. All right, by scaling out, that means that you could maximize your earning power here. So I wanted to lock in gains right here. So 1,500 shares got chomped off right here. I think I started with taking off 1,000 first. So I sold 1,000 shares first, and then I sold another 500 shares in this same minute bar. And then I let the rest go, and then sold right before the break of $3. I could have waited to see if $3 broke and held, which it did. I should have probably left a little bit more on the table. But like I said, this was so extended already. And, you know, it's $200 right here in about 3 minutes. So I'm not going to get too greedy. And that's the way I like to scale out. So you added more money by letting some shares run to catch more of that momentum. But as you can see here, which is normally the case, I've said this so many times, these will be good for the first, you know, 30 minutes or so. So 7 o'clock in the morning, that's when a lot of platforms open. And you can see here when I was trading it, that I was trading it during the biggest volume. That's what you like to do. Now what happens, because a lot of people are just simply not up yet, all right? It's 4:30 on the West Coast. A lot of people are just not awake. A lot of traders are just not awake yet. So what we do is we take advantage of the first move. A lot of times this will fade back down to VWAP, and then you come, you know, 8 o'clock, 8:30, 9 o'clock, and this stock will still be in play unless another stock takes over with a better catalyst and a lower float, because this is a very high float stock. So that's it. That's how we made $200 today, very early in the morning, just scalping this. You can see here, 4 orders, 14 fills. I got filled in pieces because it was 2,000 shares. So, you know, when liquidity was a little bit lower, it was a little bit tougher to get in, but not really. I mean, I still got filled, you know, within a couple of seconds before the move really took off. So that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hit the thumbs up and consider subscribing if you find this interesting. All right. Take care, guys. Have a good one.